According to Enos Masheja, the Bukimbiri sub-county LC3 chairman, there are about 120 Batwa households in the sub-county. Despite being known as very hard-working people, the Batwa have stayed a habit of mining about self-development. In many cases, they have been observed leasing land to non-Batwa people in the area at less than 20,000 shillings per person, as Masheja explains.
Greediness, I can say so. They want money, they and them. So they will not stop that kind of habit because they want money day and night.
Constant Tindimwewa, a Mutwa from Mukongo village in Nyundo sub-county, admits that some Batwa lease the land at 5,000 shillings, while others exchange it for 1 kilogram of posho for the whole season. However, some of them do it as a punishment at the local level once they plead guilty to any crimes committed. Tindimwewa appeals for laws at the village level to prohibit the Batwa from renting out the land. This happens because when people see the Batwa trying to productively use their land, they coordinate with LC1s to dupe them into hiring it out, and we end up remaining poor. Locals in the area use this method as a way of punishing the Batwa. They tell us to lease our land once found guilty of any crime committed, hence making the Batwa continue to live in poverty. Bowaz Arinaitwe, the Kisoro District Police Community Liaison's officer, says that the voice of the Batwa leasing land instead of utilizing it for self-development has led them to remain in poverty. As a result, many of them end up being implicated in petty cases of theft, while others have remained living as casual laborers.
It's true. If you have a small land and you hire it out, those who are hiring the land, they will be given a little money, which will not stay for long. And instead of them digging their land, plant crops for feeding them, feeding their children, in the shortest possible time, money will be used. So I'm advising the Batwa group that if they have a small land, they should cultivate the land and harvest food which will feed their people.
Penina Zaninka, the United Organization for Batwa Development in Uganda coordinator, attributes the continued vice of the Batwa to lease land to lack of capital and agricultural inputs. Zaninka, however, says that in partnership with the government, the Batwa are being sensitized to partner with other locals who have seeds so that they utilize the land and later share the harvests instead of leasing it out.
We encourage them not to really focus on hiring because their children also needs to eat. And by the time we created awareness to everyone who is a well-wisher to purchase the land, it was because of their landlessness.
Kamadi Bionabe, the Director of Research, Education and Documentation at the Uganda Human Rights Commission, says however much they train the Batwa, the decision to hire out land depends on an individual. It is the responsibility of all stakeholders to keep advising the Batwa how it is more beneficial to utilize the land themselves.
We've talked to them about their right to own land. We've taken them through the existing land tenure systems and the grievance handling mechanisms in case they have issues to do with the land ownership.
Batwa, a semi-nomadic pygmy tribe, lived in the jungles of Echuya, Bwindi, and Magahinga forests as hunters and gatherers for centuries, until 1992, when the government evicted them from their ancestral dwelling to conserve wildlife without providing alternative land. In recent years, non-government organizations and religious bodies, led by the United Organization for Batwa Development in Uganda, African International Christian Ministry, Diocese of Muhabura, and Lift Up Jesus Global Ministries intervened with a purchase of land portions and gave it to Batwa. The Batwa community was supposed to construct houses on the land and use another part for agriculture. However, the Batwa have instead started leasing land portions given to them by the aid agencies to get quick money for survival. Report compiled by Job Namanya for the news.